First, PGA play is suspended for the foreseeable future. The next three or four tournaments have been completely canceled. I don't know that they are going to be rescheduled. I don't think they can be, according to the schedule. The Masters is postponed. That is a staple of April. It is the week after the NCAA tournament finishes, after the Final Four. It's a tradition unlike any other, as CBS would tell you. But this year, however, it will not be going on that weekend. They're going to push back as far as they can, but here's the facts on this matter. Augusta is not a summer golf course. This is a winter play golf course, winter and spring. They don't even let members play on that golf course in the summer. It's not built for that. It is built for that specific time of year. And if they can't fit it in before we get into the summer months, I don't know how they're going to play it. So we may have a year without a Final Four and without a PGA tournament, without a Masters. And that is absolutely incredible. Now, you had to expect that this was coming. Now, the PGA, as of yesterday, had said that they were going to continue, but without fans. And I thought, okay, this kind of makes sense, because the only other person that you were going to be in contact with is your caddy, really. Like, you don't have to be right in the same vicinity as another golfer. You don't have to be. You can send guys out one at a time, let them play, do their thing, and it's just one guy on a course, and they don't have to be around anybody. But they decided to nix the whole thing anyway. On the other side, UFC has decided that they are going to continue with their fights. Now, they have not given an update on the fight in Brooklyn on April 18th between Khabib and Tony Ferguson. They did not give an update on that, but the next two fight nights, the one in London, the one in Brazil, they will have those. They will be without fans. They will continue so that there is programming on ESPN. Dana White called, talked to Donald Trump. They discussed it, said it would be a good idea to keep it going. So we will at least have UFC fights. And that kind of makes sense, so long as guys are being tested or whatever. I would make sure that they are tested before they're in the ring or in the octagon against each other. I don't know how they're going to do that because there's not enough tests, but either way, this is really interesting stuff, because all of these other, like, all it takes is for one fighter or one fighter's corner to have a problem, and then you got to cancel the whole thing. You got to figure out who was around. You got to quarantine for however many days. It could be a disaster. I don't know why UFC would continue on if everybody else is canceled as well. I'm kind of glad that they're not. Like, I'm glad that they are continuing, because it gives us something to watch on Saturday night. But, you know, I mean, we'll see exactly what happens.